year 2002, an unsettling event occurred. An entire infantry unit of the army mysteriously disappeared. They were on a routine patrol mission in the rugged terrains of the Kandahar mountain range in Afghanistan, a region known for its harsh and unpredictable conditions. As part of their standard operating procedures, they were supposed to maintain regular radio communication, reporting their status and any notable occurrences. However, on this particular day, radio silence ensued. The unit, which had been actively communicating, abruptly stopped. They ceased all radio transmissions, leaving their higher command in the dark. No one knew what was happening. The situation was alarming, as the sudden lack of communication was highly uncharacteristic of a disciplined military unit. The situation was puzzling, as the unit didn't signal a troops in contact, or TIC, a distress code used when under enemy attack. This code typically prompts immediate reinforcements. However, there was no such call, causing an unsettling silence and leaving higher command and fellow soldiers worried due to the lack of communication and absence of a tick alert. The infantry unit's sudden disappearance without issuing a distress signal or any communication about a potential firefight or ambush was highly unusual. In response, the Army deployed the elite Army Green Berets to locate the missing soldiers and uncover the mystery behind their vanishing. The Army Green Berets arrived and conducted an extensive search operation in the mountainous terrain to find the missing infantry unit. They meticulously combed through the mountainside, demonstrating their training and discipline. In the early days of their search, the team found no traces of the missing unit or enemy forces. They spent their days navigating the mountains with their heavy gear. Eventually, they discovered a distinct path resembling those used by local goats leading up the mountain. Operating in enemy territory, they remained vigilant and prepared for potential conflicts. The complex cave systems added to the danger and difficulty of their mission. Despite their slow progress, they continued their search. After days of searching, the team decided to follow the goat trail, hoping it would lead them to a vantage point on the other side of the mountain. As they ascended, they discovered scattered pieces of American military equipment, including radios and backpacks, along with uniforms matching those of the missing infantry unit. This discovery heightened the urgency of their mission and served as a stark reminder of the fate that may have befallen their comrades. Each item they found became a clue, guiding them closer to finding the missing unit. As the team followed the trail of discarded equipment and uniforms, they discovered bone fragments scattered on the ground. While unsure if they were human bones, their presence intensified the mission. The highly trained Army Green Berets understood the gravity of this discovery. As a former Navy SEAL, I have great respect for the Green Berets and their capabilities in handling challenging and dangerous missions. Their training prepares them for complex situations like this, where the stakes are high. The comprehensive training provided to units like the Green Berets and Navy SEALs prepares them for a wide range of situations. When faced with unsettling signs like scattered equipment, uniform fragments, and bones, their immediate thought is that the missing infantry unit may have fallen into an ambush. The trail they followed led them towards the potential site of the ambush, transforming the mission into a potentially dangerous confrontation. This realization heightened their alertness and caution as they prepared to uncover the truth. The team strategically advances up the mountain, taking defensive stances and moving slowly while keeping their weapons aimed forward. They reach a plateau where they find more scattered equipment and numerous strategically positioned cave entrances. The site of the caves, coupled with the scattered equipment, suggests that this may be the location where the missing infantry unit encountered trouble. However, upon closer inspection, they realize that the cave entrances lead to precipitous drops. Considering the potential hazards and the clear indications of a violent incident, they decide that entering the caves is too risky. This decision reflects their training and understanding of the situation, prioritizing the safety of the team and avoiding further loss. The team retreats and establishes defensive positions near the cave entrances. Suddenly, a spear is thrown from one of the caves, piercing through a teammate named Dan. Witnessing this horrifying moment, the team is shocked and on high alert. As they prepare for further attacks, a giant man, towering between 12 to 15 feet tall, emerges from the cave. He is wild-looking, clad in animal skins, and lets out a war cry as he charges towards Dan. The team swiftly engages the giant, managing to take him down within 30 seconds. The unexpected appearance of the giant and the intense battle add another layer of complexity and danger to their mission. In the aftermath of the intense encounter, Dan and the giant were both down. The team, in a state of disbelief, checked on Dan, but sadly found that he had succumbed to his injuries. They relayed the bizarre events to headquarters, describing how the giant creature had fatally wounded Dan. In response, headquarters dispatched two helicopters, one for evacuating the team and Dan's body, and another specifically for retrieving the creature. Securing the creature, which had unusual physical features, proved to be a significant challenge. Eventually, they managed to hoist it onto the helicopter and return to base. The helicopter carrying the creature was directed to an airfield where it was met by a crew from a C-130, a large military aircraft. The creature was to be transferred to this aircraft, presumably for further examination and investigation. The team was left to ponder the extraordinary events they had just experienced, awaiting further instructions upon their return to base. The pilot of the aircraft carrying the creature would later publicly confirm the unusual features of the creature: a towering figure standing between 12 to 15 feet tall, with six fingers on each hand and six toes on each foot. However, his statement was later redacted and classified as top secret. Meanwhile, Mr. K and his team returned to the base and began preparing their after-action report, a standard procedure in the military following any operation. In their report, they honestly described the extraordinary encounter: the giant with six fingers on each hand and six toes on each foot, the thrown spear that fatally wounded Dan, and the subsequent engagement. However, their leadership rejected this report, instructing them to rewrite it. The revised report, according to Mr. K, was a sanitized version of events that made it sound like a typical engagement with the enemy. The incident was then classified as top secret, and the team was required to sign non-disclosure agreements, prohibiting them from discussing the incident. Despite the secrecy and the lack of clarity about what happened to the creature's body, Mr. K decided to break his silence in 2016. Motivated by the memory of his fallen comrade, he publicly shared the details of their encounter with the giant of Kandahar. The story raises many questions. If there were indeed giants hidden from the world, Afghanistan, with its remote and rugged terrain, would be a plausible location. The landscape can feel otherworldly, and the incident in question involved the loss of a soldier and multiple corroborating testimonies. However, much of this information has been classified and redacted, leaving us with more questions than answers. I'm curious to hear your thoughts on this story. Do you believe it's true, or do you think it's a hoax? If you enjoyed this story, please like and subscribe to my channel and turn on post notifications. I post stories like this 3 to 4 times a week. If that's what you're interested in, you're in the right place.